sometimes you just hear these words like trauma-informed or trauma or toxic stress, and you don't even know what to do with that. My name is Rebecca Feinstein, and I am a preschool behavior health therapist here at Starfish. Half of my position is supporting the Head Start program, and my specific site is Plymouth Canton. And I provide Trauma Smart coaching, and I'm running the Smart Connections this year, and in the moment support and classroom support there. And then the other part of my position is as an infant health therapist, so I do have a small caseload of my own where I provide therapy to those families. Honestly, going into it, I was a little skeptical. Our Head Start program has a lot of curriculums that they use and a lot of things that teachers are expected to do, and I wasn't sure if this was going to be something that was helpful. And then when I started to learn about it, I really got bought in because I think it's something new that we're trying. It's a different way of thinking about something rather than giving the teacher something else to do. It's more about a paradigm shift. I think it kind of demystified the concept of trauma a little bit. I think that can be like a really big, scary word for people, and something where it's like, I don't even know where to start with that. And Trauma Smart really provided us with a common language, a way to talk about it, and really a way or an opportunity to step back and take a moment to go slower and be thoughtful about our reactions as well as the children's. For me, the coaching has been like the most exciting part because it's allowed me to form stronger relationships with the teachers. Just hearing them and hearing their concerns and being able to validate them before I try to respond or try to problem solve, I think is really powerful. Sometimes that's really all that they want or need. And then that actually allows them to be able to move forward without me really having to give them any sort of suggestion or solution. So that's been really powerful. But in terms of the kids, I really like the idea of the back seat and the trunk because it's really helped us understand when it would be appropriate to have a conversation with a child. If they're in the trunk of their brain, that is not something they're going to be able to hear or be receptive to because they don't feel safe. So in those moments, it's more about providing safety than validating feelings or providing connection. And being able to differentiate between those two needs, I think, has been so helpful for the teachers. They've been able to really view behavior in a different way. When I see a child who's made a bunch of progress from day one to even, you know, 3 months later, you've seen progress. Or you see a teacher who is able to advocate for herself in a way she wasn't able to before, and like, she's excited about it. Or you have someone come to you like, hey, you know, I validated a feeling and like it actually worked. Like it's really, it's validating for me to have those conversations and to see that.